Hey everybody, just wanted to welcome you to our 8 hours of prayer, our 9 to 5 prayer event this evening. And we're excited that you're here, excited that you're purposing to spend a little bit of extra time with the Lord tonight as we all join together in prayer. Just wanted to give you a heads up on how this is kind of going to roll out. Each hour on the hour, we're going to go ahead and release a new video, and that will just give you a little bit of a spiritual encouragement, a little bit of a mini devotion that we're sharing, and then there'll be some worship music following it, just to kind of help you stay awake on one hand, and on the other hand, just to give you a little bit of spiritual encouragement each hour as you seek the Lord. This whole thing kind of got started with just reading through the passage in Matthew when Jesus is going to pray in Gethsemane before he faces the cross. And so kind of the background of this, Jesus has already washed the disciples' feet. Jesus has already spent time fellowshipping with them and shared communion with them and broken bread with them. And now here at the end of the evening, starting in verse 36, so in Matthew chapter 26, starting in verse 36, here's what the text says. Jesus went with them to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." And taking with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee, he began to be sorrowful and troubled. Then he said to them, "My soul is very sorrowful, even to death. Remain here and watch with me." And going a little further, he fell on his face and prayed, saying, "My Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will." And he came to the disciples and found them sleeping. And he said to Peter, "So could you not watch with me 1 hour? Watch and pray that you might not enter temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak." Again, for the second time, he went away and prayed, "My Father, if this cannot pass unless I drink it, your will be done." And again, he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were heavy. And so leaving them again, he went away and prayed for a third time, saying the same words again, and he came to the disciples and said to them, "Sleep and take your rest later on. See, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise and let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand." And so Jesus, in his most vulnerable time that he's ever faced in his life, he's going before the Father in prayer. He's purposing to pray before he faces the cross. And he's inviting the disciples to be there with him as he does that. In particular, Peter, James, and John, he brings with him and says, "Pray with me, stay awake and pray with me that you might not enter temptation." And so tonight, as we get into the later hours of the night, you're going to be feeling maybe a little bit more tired than normal. And it seems very easy to stop praying and seeking the Lord. We'd invite you to just purpose to do that, to spend time with the Lord in prayer. You know, so many people go throughout their day and they forget the importance of prayer. And this is just an opportunity to refix our gaze before we celebrate Easter next week, to refix our gaze on the Lord and to be those disciples that sit and pray with Jesus.
Father of kindness, you have